And it's funny, I've got myself out there on Patreon now. If you haven't seen my Patreon account, this is where all this content goes first for 1 week. And then after it's been shown there for 1 week, it then goes live to the public on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, all that stuff. But Patreon is now where all my content goes first because on the wage that I earn doing the job that I do from my 9 to 5, which is a high school teacher, I need to be innovative in order to help pull in the finances I need, especially for this trip.
So the boat is longer than 8 feet by about 3 inches, 4 inches. Because of that, when I do get a piece of plywood, and I gotta see if what I have is long enough. Actually, let's go turn on the lights. I have a sheet of ply. Now it needs to go from the transom all the way along this top section. Right now I'm just looking at doing a top piece from here to the top of the arch, gunnel to the top of the arch. Not sure what this part of the boat is called. If any of you know, please let me know. And it tapers in from frame 6, tapers in 7, 8, and then it's going to get smaller and smaller. Around here, I think I will be putting, because this is going to be flimsy, but I think I will be putting a support of some sort. But again, I think I need to place the wood first and then work out what type of support I need afterwards, so that when I do the port side, it'll work out nice. Only trouble is an 8 foot piece I'll have to kind of chop off here. I'll extend this block both sides so that I can tie. Actually, I might just extend it this side, so then I can go from the transom to here with no issues. And there is a space differential between the transom and the first frame. So I think I need to build this bit out. Not sure exactly what happened, and that's okay. Part of the all a part of the quest. But as I place this piece of wood across the frames, I can see I'm just over 1/16 of an inch shy on matching up with the transom. So I got to figure out, and it's only here, I'm only short here. So I think what I might do, and I'm not sure yet, I'm either going to do, actually, I think I might have to do wood just to keep the continuity. Or it might not even matter, because at this point, because I am going to have a shift in grain, I'm going to have a clean cut down on this section here. Because of that, I might be able to do some sort of pattern. I was going to say I might have to paint it, but maybe if I have like a painted kind of swoosh on the, so this whole section up here would be painted, the design, and then it goes into the wood, then that would hide this little transition, or this transition here where it goes from one piece of wood to another, because the grains will not match up. And it's plywood, this is 5 mil ply, not going to be big enough for, it's not going to be thick enough for what I need. So yes, the issues of boat making, but I love it. I got the wood in the car. I went to Home Depot. I found some wood. Just looking at how best to do the next level. If I have these battens to the top. I'll probably have this one taller right now.
and that will give me this will give me a nice edge to lay the board on. I won't bore you with the sitting and the staring, but I'm going to clamp this into place so I can kind of get my next run up at this project figured out in my head. I think I'm just going to go ahead and do this. Gorilla Glue, come to the rescue. And I'm going to clamp that in. And then down the side, and I should be good. So let's get on with it.
Those of you that don't know, we actually have a brand new podcast, and it's up on the website. When you go to the website, just click the link for the podcast, and there you are. You can subscribe on iTunes, Stitcher, and a bunch of different platforms, I believe. So, go check that out. I'm actually going to be releasing a new podcast this weekend for patrons, and then next week it will be available for everyone else. So go check that out. The link is in the description below.
I think on these two end pieces, I'm going to countersink a little hole and put some screws in here. Even if I take them out later, but I think right now that needs to be supported. So let me get my drill. I think what I'm going to do is just use a couple of sheetrock screws for now. And I've not really gone too far into the surface. Again, just to keep the wood pressed tightly into the gunnel. So I figured I would use this one as the one that I chop. This will run right up to the transom. I wanted to kind of give a nod to American Boathead. In some of his live video feeds, he actually has a painting like this, smaller than this one. This one's quite huge. This one's about 4.5 feet across. And I saw this at my father-in-law's house. You know, he was gonna get rid of it. I said, I'd love this one. So I grabbed it, since I do love galleons.
I went to Home Depot and I went to get some 5mm ply, and I was actually looking at the wrong side, and I really like the finish on the one side, and I was waiting to get it cut when I looked at the opposite side, which on all the other boards were pretty horrendous, and I thought, oh my goodness, this is the one I need to use. So at the front on one side, I was able to get what is a little bit like a shark's eye, right on the tip of the bow on the starboard side, and on the other side, just a beautiful piece of grain. The very nose, the very, you know, where the apex meets, where the two boards meet on the bow, joined to the stem, there will be a piece of stainless steel angle metal there, so protecting it. So the join will be protected, but again, I will be fiberglassing everything and making sure that that resin gets into all those fibers. Again, as stated earlier, I do actually have a podcast up and running. It's live on iTunes. I also believe it's live on Stitcher, and pretty much for every platform that that you need. On the website, you can actually access it. Just go to the podcast page on thegreatamericanboattour.com and click podcast, and there you are. And there's a myriad of ways that you can follow that. I might be recording you. I might be interviewing you about your boats, your builds, how you got started, why you got started. I think the whys are just as important as anything. So let me know and subscribe to the podcast to eventually hear weekly shows on all this type of thing, building boats and more. And this just only goes to show that I needed to taper the stem. The bow panel touches the gunwale. It tries to, but this little bit is in the way, so I need to kind of taper it off. I got the top pattern. And it's funny, you know, I've got myself out there on Patreon now. If you haven't seen my Patreon account, this is where all this content goes first for 1 week. And then after it's been shown there for 1 week, it then goes live to the public on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, all that stuff. But Patreon is now where all my content goes first, because you know, on the wage that I earn doing the job that I do from my 9 to 5, which is a high school teacher, you know, I need to be innovative in order to help pull in the finances I need, especially for this trip. A lot of the tools that I have now have been purchased in moments of financial strength. You know, I've had moments where I've had a little bit of extra cash, and sometimes I haven't had the cash, but I went ahead and did it anyway. And I've not regretted anything to date, but I have a lot of clamps. I do. I have all the basics for sure. But tomorrow I have the honor of going to a friend's father's house that sadly, very sadly, passed away earlier this week. And I got a call today, in fact, that they'd like me to go and take a look at the tools that are available. So, you know, very sad. And I'll try and find a way to honor, because stuff like that for me is, I'm a very, very sentimental person. I can go all the way to Arizona, having wanted to go there all my life, and I'll find a pine cone. You know, a little stone, a little pine cone, that stuff to me is worth its weight in gold. I'll put that in a little curio cabinet, and I just remember back when, you know. And to have someone past that's been in a trade, a skilled craftsman's trade, and now to put their tools to use is
is a huge honor for me. I look at, so I won't give the details of who and where, but hopefully in the next video I'll show you some of the tools that I was given. Life, right? People dropping like flies, especially the older you get. I think that's why I like to live it. That's why I like to do crazy stuff like this. Why the heck not? What's life about if we can't follow our dreams, our passions? That's what I love to tell my kids, both my students and my actual kids, who are also my kids.